welcome to the last chapter of our training. So far, we have explored a range of different features available in VirusTotal to help with the analysis of malware to gain threat context. However, for the most part, we did it manually. Every day, SOC analysts have to deal with thousands of alerts, more than 90% of which are automatically processed. The same is true for the large sets of indicators of compromise we want to investigate. In this final chapter, we will explore the possibilities that VirusTotal API offers to automate all the tasks that we have discussed, as well as how to integrate with existing solutions in our security stack.
VirusTotal API is behind all the functionality VirusTotal offers. That means that we should be able to automate everything we can do in the web interface. The main resource for anything API related is the documentation. Additionally, we can find other tools that also use VirusTotal's API to implement functionality and can be also useful for us to automate tasks, like VT CLI. In both cases, you will need to specify your API key. Here is how you can find it. Let's start by using VT CLI to download a samples report. In this case, we should use the File option. It returns an object in JSON format. Anything the API returns is an object with a type, like a file, an IP, or a submission. Details are provided in the documentation, but basically contains the same data that is offered on the website. We can also use it to do any VTI query the same way we use the web interface. The query will return the whole reports for all resulting files, not only the hashes. If we would like only identifiers, we should use the -i option. There is a limit to 10 results by default. We can change that within -n. Finally, the previous query returned a cursor at the end, meaning there are more results for our query we can retrieve by executing it. VirusTotal API's official version is V3. You can find legacy code and integrations still using V2. V2 endpoints are still operative, but using V3 is highly recommended as it provides far more endpoints than V2, and results provide more data. Any future feature will have its corresponding V3 endpoint. If we need to implement a script, we can find dozens of examples with most usual use cases in the GitHub repository. In case of using Python, there is a dedicated library called VTPy, which makes interacting with VirusTotal easier. Here we can also find examples for the most usual use cases, including uploading the scanning files, retrieving information for any indicator, downloading files, or managing your YARA rules. This all helps us automate any tasks. For instance, in this example, we see how all interactions and results have dedicated objects when using VTPy, which makes things way easier. VirusTotal's web interface, graph, and collections, they all have limits to the number of objects we can manage. The API allows us to download all of the information we need to override any limits and to analyze it using our own methods.
Before we jump into how VirusTotal can be integrated into any third-party software within your security stack, we want to thank you for your interest in learning more about how VirusTotal can assist you with your investigations. We encourage you to check any additional resources that you can find as part of our VirusTotal Academy and to give us your feedback. And now, let's get back to third-party integrations.
We saw we can use VirusTotal's API to automate anything we need. This is, in essence, what many security solutions use to automate their flows as well. SOARs, CMs, EDR, and other third-party solutions will automatically retrieve information from VirusTotal to get context for any indicator. VirusTotal's documentation offers some details and examples. In some cases, third parties have dedicated integrations in their own marketplaces. Nevertheless, VirusTotal's APIs is always under the hood. We can always create our own implementation using it. Integrations can be very different among all types of security products, including CMs, SOARs, and EDRs. VirusTotal's data is usually offered for enrichment as part of playbooks for automation, but use cases might differ. The only requirement is usually using your API key. If software we use does not provide any integration, we cannot easily do it ourselves, but we can always use VT4Browsers++, VirusTotal's browser extension. This extension automatically detects any indicator in the website we're using and enriches the details using VirusTotal's data. The data is displayed using VT Augment, VirusTotal's widget also integrated in several third parties. The extension additionally helps submitting data to VirusTotal and provides different shortcuts to analysts, which can be a very convenient addition to our workbench.